We want to simplify the given expression, so we'll have to follow the order of operations, so we'll have to square these binomials first. So we'll have the quantity x minus 3 times the quantity x minus 3 minus the quantity x minus 8 times the quantity x minus 8. Now we'll have to find this product, and then determine the difference. So we'll have four products here, 1, 2, 3, 4, as well as four products here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So to keep this organized, let's put this product in a set of brackets. So we'll have x times x, that's x squared. And then we're going to have x times negative 3, that's going to be minus 3x. And then we'll have negative 3 times x, that's another minus 3x. Then we'll have negative 3 times negative 3, that's going to be plus 9. Minus, now we'll find this product, so we'll have x times x, that's x squared. Then we'll have x times negative 8, that's minus 8x. And then negative 8 times x is another minus 8x. And then we have negative 8 times negative 8, that'll be plus 64. Now the reason we need these brackets is we have to subtract this entire polynomial. But before we do that, let's combine our like terms. Here we have two x terms, and here we have two x terms. So we have x squared, this would be minus 6x plus 9, minus, here we'll have x squared minus 16x plus 64. And now we're going to clear these parentheses so that we can combine the like terms. So we can think of putting a positive 1 here and distributing. And then because we're subtracting this entire polynomial, if we put a 1 here, we'll distribute a negative 1, which will change the sign of each of these terms. So again, distributing a 1 is not going to change anything here. We'd have x squared minus 6x plus 9, but then here we're going to have minus x squared or minus 1x squared, if that's helpful. And here we have a negative times a negative, that's going to be plus 16x. Here we have a negative times a positive, that'll be negative 64 or minus 64. And the last step will be to combine like terms. We have two x squared terms. We have two x terms. And we also have two constants. Looking at the x squared terms, we can think of this as 1x squared. So 1x squared minus 1x squared, that would be 0. And then for the x terms, this is negative 6x plus 16x. Since negative 6 plus 16 is 10, this would be 10x. And then we have 9 minus 64, that's going to be negative 55, so we have minus 55. This would be our simplified expression.